So some of you have asked me about my personal flotation device, aka float tube. I want to talk to you a little bit about why I chose the boat that I use. And it's been a great boat. So it is from Outcast Sporting Gear, and it's the Fat Cat. Fat Cat meaning it's a little bit larger. I'm kind of a big guy, tall guy, so I kind of wanted something that was on the larger side. It's super compact. I can stuff it in the back of the Jeep, half inflated. I can even put it in the trunk of my car if I need to. So it's really easy to move around. It's also very lightweight. I mean, I could pack this thing up with all my gear and easily carry it down to the water's edge. It's got lots of storage up front. As you can see, I have a dry bag to where it does get wet in that little alcove back there. So I have a dry bag that keeps all of my, I don't know, extra clothes, wallet, keys, cell phone, that kind of thing, all in there dry and accessible if I ever need it. It also has room for my net. It has lots of storage, as you can see. I can put a ton of fly boxes in this float tube really easily. A lot of times I'll have some water in there as well, but pretty much anything and everything that I would need still water fishing, I can put in these little storage containers. It's got a couple other small little containers that I've got a pair of backpack straps just in case I need to carry this in a little ways, or if I just want to have a little extra room for storage. You can see kind of the little D-ring up front. That's if you want to put a water bottle or a beer can or whatever might be your pleasure up front for drinks. It does kind of get in the way when it's up there. It's got a nice apron that you put on, so it keeps your fly line out from underneath your legs. I generally never put fish up there just because it's kind of a rough mesh and I don't want to hurt the fish or remove their protective slime by putting them up on top. Even though it's got a little scale there, I never use it. It's more just kind of a workstation or an area to catch my fly line. What else? Oh, some of you have asked, what do I use for fins? So some of you keen observers might notice that these are not wading boots because I brought my corkers with me, but I didn't bring my wading boots that are specifically designed for fins. I've got big feet, so these size 15 wading boots don't fit in the nose of those fins very well. So I have a extra set of wading boots that I use specifically for when I'm out in the float tube that are narrower in design and fit the toe into the fin. So I had to grab a old crappy pair of sneakers because there was no way I was getting those fins over my corker. So, but I use US diving fins. I've had these fins for 20 years and I like to be able to really propel myself quickly around the lake. And these diving fins move you really easily without a lot of effort. So that's why I chose those fins. And man, they've been bulletproof. I mean, I've had those things for a really long time and they just never had any problems with them. So I prefer those over the typical fins that you find for float tube fishing. It has one single bladder, which, you know, it's kind of, I wish there were two bladders just because if you have a problem, I've never had a leak, but if you had a problem, there's a foam cushion underneath the seat, but I don't think it'll keep me afloat. So I've got a flotation device in my dry bag just in case one of those CO2 ones, you pull the string, just in case I get in trouble. But if that would be the only thing that I could change, that's what I would change, is having a dual bladder system. What else? Oh, you can see it's got a little place to where you can put your rod. So I put my second rod down in this area, and you want to always use those little Velcro straps so you never lose a rod off the back or off the front when you're playing a fish, because it's really easy to get distracted when you got a fish on, and you know, you want to make sure that you have both rods when you leave. So I always strap that down on those Velcro straps. So, well, I am here at my secret spot. So that's my float tube, and it's a great boat. I'll leave a link down at the description of this video if you guys want to check it out. All right, let's go fishing. Fish on.